you're gonna start on the back. I usually don't really start on the back, but if it's the time of the month, maybe we should. So just come down onto your mat first here. And just tuck the knees into the chest, getting a little bit smaller, but like really being aware here, how does the lower back actually lays flat down on the mat. And then just close your eyes for a moment, hug the knees in a little bit higher up, but relax the shoulders. So don't tense the shoulders up here, but trying to keep the shoulder blades flat on the mat. And then imagine you have like a clock underneath your sacrum, and you just want to do like really small circuits here with the sacrum on the mat, just moving the lower back along that clock, imaginary clock. So start with small circuits, and then if you like, if you feel like, can always make them bigger. Be mindful here when you're moving a little bit towards the left and right side. Always listen to your body. Like if it feels good on the spine, don't give too much pressure in here. And then eventually just find your way back to center and swap directions. So again, small, start with small and slowly build it up from over here. So might feel a little bit stiff here, lower back, especially like when it's the time of the month, like sometimes we feel a little bit of tension, especially in the lower back. So it's nice to give this a little bit of an intention here in your practice today. So we're coming back to center, hug the knees into the chest, and then just place the arms towards the sides. So check that your palms are facing downwards, and that the shoulder are pulling down here. Now we're moving everything over, so the kneecaps are moving over towards the left side, and you might feel like, okay, I have to go a little bit backwards again with the buttocks. So please do a tiny step with the buttocks back on the mat, so just that it feels a little bit more comfortable. All right, then turn your head towards the right hand. And if you want to intensify the stretch, you can also place that left hand on the top of your right kneecap and mindfully pull it a little bit downwards here. Try to pull the right shoulder even further down. And then this is the moment where you can take a deep breath in. Exhale out through the open mouth. One more time, take a deep breath in, especially here, lower back area feels so nice. Exhale out. Notice how your body is getting a little bit softer the more you're going to repeat this. One more time, take a deep breath in. Exhale everything out. Then just come back to center. Tuck the knees into the chest again, and this time place your hands onto the kneecaps and just give it a little bit of a circle here. So external rotation, move the kneecaps towards the outside, then kneecaps back together. Do this a couple of times to feel into the hips. And then squeeze the kneecaps up towards the chest again, place the arms towards the side. We're just going to move over towards the other side this time. So kneecaps are moving over towards the right side. And again, do that tiny step backwards with your buttocks coming back onto the mat a little bit. And then turn your head towards your left hand. Close the eyes. And the right hand can always be on top of your left kneecap, pulling it mindfully downwards. So feel into that supine twist here on the other side. Take a deep breath in. Exhale out. One more. Take a deep breath in. Exhalation. And the final one. One more deep breath in, feel the ribs expanding a little bit. Exhale out. Alright. Come back to center. And then just place both feet down onto the mat. Extend your left leg, hug the right knee into the chest. Alright. Then with that right knee into the chest, we do like small circles here just to work into the right hip joint. Circling towards the outside and trying to mobilize a little bit. Then with your left hand, try to grab a hold of your right foot. We do like a crossover here and see if you can extend it a little bit. So you don't have to be fully straight. You just want to lengthen a little bit further that right leg. You can always have like a bend in here. Just feel a little bit into that stretch on the back side of your right leg. Now place the right hand towards the right side, palm is facing downwards. This is going to give you a little bit more stability. Now we're using that left hand and we pull it over towards the left side. Not all the way over, just a little bit. I would say like you get a good stretch here if you just go like, let's say 45 degrees. Alright? 45 degrees and then you should be able to feel like a good stretch, especially like on the outer edge of your right hip. If you feel like you're falling too much towards the side, back off a little bit, come a little bit higher up here. And then slowly come back. Release that right leg and just moving on towards the other side. Hug the left knee inwards. And then with your right hand, try to grab the left foot from the outside. Left hand is going towards the side to give you a little bit more hold, a little bit more stability. Then extend that leg, so push the heel a little bit away from you. And then we are pulling with the right arm towards the right side. So again, we're going 45 degrees so that you feel like that stretch over here on the other edge of the left side of your hip. You can also use a strap here. It's quite nice if you can't really reach it with your hand, feel free to play a little bit around with the strap, that works as well. Slowly come back to center. Okay. Now, we're bringing both kneecaps in line here. And we just place the hands on the back side of the head. Now we extend the right leg, we tap the mat, and the right elbow is coming towards the left kneecap. Okay, a little tap, then swap it. Extend the left leg, tap, left elbow, right kneecap, like really be mindful here, okay? You're not going to overdo this, just a little bit of an activation of the core to start with. Just going to do two more on each side, tapping, tap. And then just finish your sequence. Hug the knees into the chest again. And then slowly place the hands into the crease of your kneecaps. Slowly raise it a couple of times, forward and backwards. Always rounding the back. And coming back. And the next time we're actually sitting here, so try to find a little bit of length. I like to place the hands here a little bit below my kneecaps, and this kind of helps me to lift the spine. So rather than hunching the back, lift yourself up, reach up with your arms, and then let the kneecaps fall towards the sides. Push the heels together and exhale, ball forward. Healing a little bit into the hips. And then just let your head sink here. So it's always nice to stay there a little bit. Palms are facing upwards, releasing the neck and opening the hips at the same time. Then with your next inhale, slowly raise it up, bring the arms up as well. And with the exhalation, try to stretch yourself out. So legs extended, arms extended, inhale, reaching up. Hug everything in again into the chest. chest, rounding in. And then inhale, reach the arms up. Bring the kneecaps towards the sides. Exhale, walk forward. Gonna do this a couple of times here. Just to wake up the body. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, give yourself a hug, rounding in. Allow yourself and your spine to really round here, especially in the upper back, releasing the head. And then slowly reach up with your arms again. Bring the kneecaps towards the sides. Exhale, ball forward. All right, inhale, reaching up. Exhale, give yourself a hug. Okay. This time, place the hands behind you, fingertips are pointing away. Bring the feet a little bit away from you. And we're just pushing into a tabletop position. So hip bones want to go up. Can release the head, you don't have to. And exhale, sitting down again. Inhale, pushing up. And exhale, slowly coming down. One more like this. Inhale, reaching up. And exhale. Sitting down. Now this time, flip the hands. So the fingertips are pointing towards your buttocks. Inhale, push up again. And then we try to straighten the legs and we push the buttocks through the arms. You might have to come a little bit wider with the hands if the buttocks is not coming through. So inhale, pushing up. And then exhale, try to straighten the legs, just being on the heels here and push the buttocks through your arms actually. Okay, they can always slide a little bit, like backwards. And then sliding up. Sliding back. Hovering with the buttocks just above the mat. Inhale up. Exhale, hover through. Final one, inhale up. And exhale, coming through. Okay, sit down here. And then bend your right leg. Check that you're not sitting on that right heel. The left leg is extended. Inhale, reach up with your arms. Try to find some extra space, especially in the ribcage section. And then exhale, full forward bend. Check if your toes are pointing upwards on the left hand side and try to pull that right kneecap a little bit backwards, or rather downwards, I would say. Okay. Like this. So you can always walk yourself with the fingertips a little bit further into that position if you want to, but you don't have to. So take a deep breath in, exhale everything out. Then walk the hands towards you and bend the left leg. We're going to cross our hands here, doesn't matter if the right one or the left one is on top, we're just going to cross it and we grab our left foot over here. Now we push the leg up. Okay, so it's kind of a cross-ported position over here. Pull the foot a little bit higher up, direction face, and try to straighten the spine. So not like hunching over here, but kind of lifting up from the collarbone. Inhale, find a little bit of length, and with the exhalation, pull the elbows towards the sides. If you're pulling the elbows towards the sides, this allows you actually to go further with the foot upwards towards the face. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, see if you want to pull in a little bit further. Inhale again. And exhale. Alright, slowly let go of that leg. And then hug everything in again, rounding in, being kind and gentle to yourself today. And then slowly reach up with your arms, let your kneecaps fall towards the sides, exhale coming forward. See if you want to have the palms facing upwards, and you can always sway a little bit side to side here with your torso if you want to go deeper. And then walk with the fingertips towards you here. Inhale, reaching up. And exhale, stretch it all out. So legs extended, stretch the arms, find some extra space in the lower back here. And just take a deep breath in. Exhale out. Come back to center. Okay. Now we're bending the left leg. Just check if the sitting bones are still grounded towards the mat. So get the sitting glute out here if you need to. Check that the toes are pointing all the way upwards. And then inhale, reach up first. And with the exhalation, go forward. You can always, if you want, you can always place the hands here onto the hip bones. And this actually helps you to bowl with a straight spine coming forward. All right? So see what works here for you. As always, we don't want to push the heart downwards, but rather like forward to create some extra space. And then just connect yourself with your breath. So especially in those moments where we feel like stressed, everything is feeling overwhelming, we tend to do even more. We tend to do even more of the things that are written on our to-do lists. But the thing is, like, we should do actually less. We should do less and we should focus more and ask ourselves, what do I actually need today? Because most of the times we are like in this very yang energy, so the masculine energy, which is like, I have to perform, I have to do. But especially when we are feeling stressed, we need to come a little bit more into that receiving yin energy. Where we really ask ourselves, okay, what do I need? And most of the times we know it intuitively, we just don't listen to it. Alright, walk the fingertips towards you again. Then bend that right leg. Go for the crossover with your hands. Oh no, am I frozen? My picture is frozen. Why is that? Hey, can you see me? Hear me? Oh no.
Yes.
My picture was frozen somehow, so it was my connection. Sorry about that. All right, so we have the right leg extended and the left one is bent. Right.
Let me just check. Oh, yeah, should be working now. All right.
So right leg is extended, the left one is bent. Okay, now we're gonna cross our arms again. We bent that leg. We try to grab a hold. If you can't touch your outer edges of the feet, then just grab the ankle, everything, anything that is available to you. Lift it up and then slowly shoot that heel away from you. So again, you don't have to go for the full extended leg. You can always keep a little micro bend. And then inhale, try to find a little bit of an uplift in your spine. And with the exhalation, pull the elbows towards the sides. So bending the elbows, and this allows you actually to push a little bit higher with the toes towards the base. All right, take a deep breath in. Exhale, pull. One more, deep breath in. And exhale, pull it towards you. Back in. And then slowly let it go. Now we're just going to use our strap here for the moment. chocolate, scarf, can be anything that you have at home. Around the mid-foot section, so both sides. What we're gonna do here, like we come a little bit closer, so we have like more of a control, so belly on the thighs. And then we come like halfway up into this kind of Navasana boat position. And imagine you wanna push the feet away from you, but of course you can't because the strap is gonna hold you. And then bend the elbows, and this way you can actually improve the posture, right? So hold it, imagine someone's gonna pull you up here from the collarbone. And now we're just slowly gonna extend the legs. Can point the toes, you can have them flex, can play a little bit around, pull the strap towards you. See if you want to go a little bit higher. Don't forget to breathe. And then come into that half hold again. Can always walk your hands along the strap if you want to have a little bit more control, walk it towards the feet. And then just extend again, pull the elbows in. So this way you can actually bring the feet closer towards the face. Alright. So elbows are pointing downwards rather than towards the side. This is going to give you more control. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Alright. Then just grab your strap only with the right hand. Come out with the left one, okay? And we're just coming back here for a quick moment, down onto the mat. So the right foot is in the strap and we hold it with our right hand. Now we're gonna use the left hand to hold the strap and the right hand is coming towards the side. Now the left hand is pulling it all the way over. Maybe not all the way down, you don't have to. But maybe a little bit wider than we did at the beginning of the class. So use the strap to guide you and then slowly pull your right leg over towards the left side. So pull it a little bit in. And you're gonna notice when you start pushing the strap towards you, the more you're gonna feel on the right side of your hip joint. So as always, don't overdo it, only go to that stretch that is still like a positive stretch for you. And allow yourself also a little moment here to release, because especially like this lateral line and the legs, it's kind of tight for a lot of people of us, and it also takes a little bit of time to release and to feel better. So if after a moment you feel like, okay, it's releasing a little bit, you can always go wider with that leg downwards. All right, slowly bring it back up again. Just swap it, come out here of the strap. Also notice the difference. Notice how your right side feels now in comparison to the left one. So my right leg now feels way more longer. It's like I have like a longer leg and a shorter one. So it kind of makes a difference because we're stretching the deep tissue over here. So just put the left foot into your strap, extend the right leg, and then just use your right hand, grab the strap with your right hand. Left arm is on the side to support you. And then pull everything over towards the right side. Again, see how far you want to go here. Probably more than 45 degrees than we did at the beginning without the strap, but probably also not all the way down. So see what feels good. As always in your practice. But in life also, I feel like we don't really ask ourselves that anymore, like, how do we feel today? Like, we're asking always other people, hey, how are you doing? But we sometimes forget just checking in with ourselves. All right, and then slowly come back again. release your strap, and slowly, a couple of times here, rolling forward and backwards again. Be mindful. Just do this like three times, and then stop yourself when you're up. Inhale, reach up with your arms, and then bring the kneecaps again towards the side, exhale, ball forward. Opening a little bit in the hips, releasing the neck. And this time come onto your fingertips, walk the fingertips over towards the left side. And then slowly walk the hands over towards the right side. Alright, then come back to center, help yourself closing the kneecaps, and we're just coming into kind of a side variation over here. If you have knee issues, I would suggest you can always double up, or you can also like come to the toes, right? You don't have to have your flat knee here. I like to tuck the toes under here a little bit, so like not that much pressure. And the left foot is parallel towards the short side of the mat. Alright, check that that right hand is right underneath your shoulder over here. And we're just circling that left arm all the way down, all the way up. And then just above that, then coming down again. Find your own flow here, feeling into the left side of your shoulder. And then also allow yourself to play a little bit around, or change directions, so came to the other side. And then just bring the fingertips onto the shoulders. Now we're moving that elbow downwards, elbow is facing down towards the mat. Inhale, elbow is facing up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Down, giving a little bit into that rotation, and then come halfway up. Flip the right palm, lean over towards the left side, come back here, right hand down, and then just sit back. All right, roll the shoulders a couple of times, then bring the fingertips onto both shoulders. Inhale, reaching up, exhale all the way down, inhale up, exhale down, one more, okay. Then again, you can be with a flat, with your toes untucked, or you can tuck them under, coming down here onto the mat, and extend the right foot. Again, right foot parallel towards the short side of the mat. We are trying to push into all four edges of the foot. And the entire left palm is down on your mat, fingers widespread. Ideally underneath your shoulders, just to make sure that you don't have too much pressure in your wrist. So pull yourself away from the mat. Reach up with that right arm. And then just start circling a little bit. Doesn't matter which direction, if you want to go internally or externally. Just feeling into the right side. And especially like opening here on the right side, rib cage area is often quite tight for us. Then swap your direction. Place the right fingers onto the right shoulder. Elbows facing up. Then exhale, elbows facing down. Coming up. Down again, bring it up, and down, and then slowly come halfway up, flip the left palm, and just circle over towards the side, coming back, and sitting back. Alright, roll the shoulders a couple of times again, interlace your fingers, Then pull the head forward and bring the chin towards your jaw. No, actually the chin towards the sternum. And then slowly open the arms again. Right hand towards the right side. Just kick it. Extension. Sit back towards the middle. Try the other side. Coming back. Finding a little bit of a floor movement here. Peeling into the side body. And you can always make your movement with the arms a little bit wider every time you're gonna repeat. So just exploring a little bit the motion of our shoulders today. And we're just gonna do one more on each side here. And then slowly sit back. All right. Now, you can sit down like this. You can always prop up the hips as well, but you can also try like to place the heels towards the outside and then sit in between. So, see how it feels here for your kneecaps. If it's like too much of a stretch, then please prop up a little bit. So this should be more like a relaxation pose, right? So make it comfy. If you need to, just use a pillow. Then just place both hands onto the kneecaps, throw your shoulders all the way up towards the ears. Exhale all the way down. Bring your hands towards heart center. And this time you're just connecting the fingertips. So the elbows are facing towards the side. And we're gonna do kind of a little moving meditation. This is how I like to call it, okay? So we inhale, we try to fill the body with air, and with the exhalation, we release the air and we turn towards the left side. Okay, so inhale, exhale. Inhale back to center. Again, left side. And then you can also close your eyes. Let's just do a set of five together. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. And then just keep on going in your own pace. Come back to center when you have done your five on the left hand side. Keep the eyes closed, just breathe in and out normally again. If you need to change your seating position, you can always change it up here. You can also come into cross seat now if you just want to change it. And then just prepare yourself for another round on the other side. So bring the fingertips together again, close your eyes. Take a deep breath in and exhalation. Inhale in. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Keep on listening to your own breath. The sequence and roll the shoulders back again. Alright, use the little strap, then pull it apart as much as you can. Keep your arms straight, and we're slightly pulling the arms behind the ears, so not all the way down yet. We're still like working a little bit to release any tightness in the upper back. So go a little bit backwards. Keep keep the arms extended, so don't stop bending. Keep them in its full length. Then come forward and round, sorry, rounding in. Inhale up. Then see if you want to stretch a little further, maybe. And especially like when you have that full stretch, take a deep breath into the rib cage so that you feel like that expansion in the chest. And exhale, round it in. Inhale up. If you want to go a little bit further, and exhale, round it in. Inhale up. You can always play around if you want to do like the full movement. You can also go for the full movement. But if it's like really unbearable, then just go a little bit wider with your hands and adjust the stance. Okay, so it gets easier the more apart, the more your hands are apart. But if you want to have a little bit of a challenge, come a little bit closer. All right. Inhale up, exhale back. And then we're just moving towards the left side only. So, left arm. And again, try to not bend the arms too much. Try to keep them extended. And then just move over towards the right side. Bring it back. Come forward. Back again. Okay, feels better already. So release your strap. Upper back feels a little bit more flowy again. And then just come onto all fours, but rather than staying with the kneecaps down, we just want to hover here. So pull the kneecaps up, and then from over here, push with the pelvis backwards. Up to that point where it doesn't go any further for you, and then slowly start straightening the legs a little bit further. Not all the way yet, but just walk the heels a little bit up and down. Check if your fingers are widespread, check if you're pushing through the knuckles of your fingers, and push yourself away from the mat. Alright? Okay. Then slowly walk the feet towards your hands. And then sitting down here into kind of a squat. Finding a little bit of space in the hips again by swaying side to side. And then slowly lifting up the buttocks again. Doing a step backwards, coming into a downward facing dog. First downward facing dog for today. Take it easy. Walk the heels up and down, finding some extra space. And then we just push the entire left heel down into the mat and we keep that right leg bent. So right kneecap is pushing forward. We're gonna feel quite of a sensation actually in our left hamstring. So try to keep that left heel down, pushing into the mat. And then just swap the foot. So right heel is pushing downwards. Feel the stretch on the back side of your right leg. And then just do it again. Left heel down, right heel down. Okay, slowly walk towards your hands again. Sitting low. Coming into that kind of squat position, this time hands towards the heart. And then slowly roll yourself all the way up. Head follows last, as always. And exhale. Come all the way down again, sitting down low. Now in this position, try to slightly open up with the left arm. And bring it back. Right arm and bring it back. Left arm again. Bring it back. Right side. Back to center. Interlace the fingers. Slowly push yourself up. And exhale. Coming all the way down again. Okay. Sit down here. right leg and the left one. Use your strap one more time. And then place the strap around the right foot. And what we're gonna do here is that we bring that right arm on the inside of the right leg. We pull the strap towards us. And we're gonna notice here, like, okay, this feels a little bit tight over here. This is where we wanna breathe in, okay? But it always helps if you just place a hand over here. And imagine how you're gonna widen that space just by breathing into that side body. So inhale and exhale. And when you exhale, actually what we wanna do here is like, that here is pushing away and we are like lifting up a little bit. This way, this part is getting wider. If we are pushing, if we have like one force that pushes this way and one that is pushing up, this is gonna get wider and more spacious. So try again. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Then stretch the arm above your head just to increase that stretch. Take a deep breath in again. Exhale out. Then slowly circle that left arm all the way down. Release the strap. Place that left hand right next to you on the mat. And then push it up into a side anchor, side opener here. Check if you're pushing with your other foot into the mat. And sitting back again. One more like this. Push yourself up, opening. And exhale, coming down. Alright, swap it. Left leg extended. Use your strap. With your left hand, try to hold the entire strap. Place the elbow on the inside of your left leg. Inhale, reach up with your arm. And again, don't collapse downwards with the chest, but try to uplift and correct yourself over here. I always like to place one hand here onto the side body. And then try to breathe into the ribs. So inhale. Feel the expansion over here on the right side. And with the exhalation, pull with the left heel away from you and lifting the spine. One more, take a deep breath in and exhale out. Bring that right arm just above your head. Palms is facing downwards, fingertips are pointing away. And don't bring that arm in front of you. We want to have that arm just in line with the ear. Okay? So this allows us to have like the most effect on the side body. So one more deep breath in, exhale, slowly coming back to center. Again, place that right hand next to you on the mat. We're gonna do that a little bit lower again. Flip the left foot down so you have a better standing grip, and then push up, open, sitting back. One more, push, side opener. And back. Okay. Now we keep on evolving a little bit with that flow. What we're going to do here is like we're coming up, we're sitting down, and then that left hand is coming behind us and the right kneecap is coming up. Now we're going to focus on that left foot. Left foot needs to flip onto the outer edge. Okay. This time we're lifting up, pushing the hip bones up, and slowly sitting back again. Keep on circling, right hand towards the side, right knee kept down, open, and then sit, left hand behind you, right knee kept up, push the hip bones up. Sitting down, one more like this, circle, circle, circle. Open, sitting back, left hand behind you, right kneecap up, flip onto the other edge, push the hip bones up. And slowly sitting back. All right. One more time, other side. So we have that left hand on the left side. We place that left kneecap down. We're pushing ourselves up. And then we sit down. Right hand is coming behind us. Left kneecap is coming up. Flip onto the outer edge of the right foot. Push the hip bones up. Then sitting back again. Circle, circle, circle. Coming to a side over, opening. Sitting back. Circle the right arm. And push the hip bones up. Sitting back. And then just bring both heels back together. Let the kneecaps fall a little bit towards the side. Walk the heels also a little bit away from the groin area. Inhale, reaching up. And exhale, surrender. Release the head. If you want, you can place your hands on the backside of the head and slightly pull yourself a little bit further down. So most of the time, when it's the time of the month, this is a moment also where we feel a little bit more like we're in our own little world, in our own cocoon, a little bit like this position actually. This is a moment where you reflect, where you also have like a lot of doubts in your life, like what am I here to do? We are more introverted in this kind of phase. And it's actually a really good moment to get rid of things. So as our body is also shedding the tissue, the same way we can also get rid of things in our life that no longer serve us. So for instance, if you feel like, okay, my apartment is a mess, I need to clean up. I want to get rid of some certain clothes or anything that doesn't really bring me joy anymore. This is like the perfect moment actually. So you can adjust not only your yoga practice, but also like how do you live? What do you do in the different phases of your cycle? This is how you can adapt. It's also a very good moment to birth something new, right? It can be an idea, it can be a project. Because this is basically what's going on in your body as well. Like we're birthing something. First, we have to get rid of something to make space for something new in the phase afterwards. All right, so slowly walk the hands in again, help yourself, bring the kneecaps together. Just check it out for a little moment. Still want to do a little pose at the end, probably not on the belly because it doesn't feel that much. but we can use a blanket or anything else. We can also use a pillow. Just anything that is soft and that you can fold. Can be a towel as well. So yeah, what I like to do is like I create this little bolster kind of shape, and I just place it on the backside, so it tucks into the sacral, that bony part, the end of your spine, and then I just lay down here onto this one. Now, if you feel like, for me, it's a little bit too low for the head, so if you need to, then also place a pillow or something just for your head so it's not gonna be too much out. And then just place your ears together. Again, kneecaps are falling towards the side. And then just place the spine onto that soft bolster. Okay? Use the pillow as much as you need it. And this is a really nice position first to open in the hips, okay? It's also a really grounding pose for you because you can feel the support of your mat. But what we do in this pose especially is like we're opening in the chest, we're opening in the heart section. So basically the heart, the chest is kind of expanding here a little bit due to the bolster. And you can just have your arms next to your body. And the thing is, like when you're feeling stressed, when you're feeling overwhelmed, most of the times you're just breathing very flatly into the chest area. And this is what our nervous system makes us feel even more anxious and stressed. So the key is, if we don't want to feel that stressed anymore, we have to breathe into the belly. So in this position, it's quite nice actually to place one hand onto the navel and the other one is coming on top. And you can just take a deep breath in here. And you're going to feel your belly expanding. And with the exhalation, just let it go. And once again, take a deep breath in. Feel the belly coming up. And exhale. And I just invite you to make your breath a little bit visible. So don't be afraid, you're just practicing in your own little space, no one's gonna watch you. So really make, especially that exhale, make it a sound. So take a deep breath in. Exhale. We're gonna count for 3 for the inhale and for 4 for the exhalation. We'll take a deep breath in and sigh it out. Alright. Then slowly walk your hands up towards the heart. Place the left hand onto your heart. And then just place the right palm on top of the left palm. And then just feel your heart beating. Feel the love, feel the space that we're creating through this pulse in our heart section. And imagine how with every breath you're going to widen that space. You're going to invite more love into your heart. Love for yourself, love for your body, understanding, especially during that time of the month where everything feels a little bit off. Like try to send yourself that positive message that everything is a cycle, especially we as women, we are working in cycles, and that's a good thing. Can be a bad thing if we want to perceive it as a bad thing, but we can also use it like nature to just rebirth after every cycle. And then just place the palms together. Place your palms right onto the forehead. Bring that awareness one more time towards the inside of you. And then slowly release the hands. Slowly open the eyes. Just help yourself here to get the kneecaps together.